The Australian Human Rights Commission is urging people to come forward if they want to lodge an official complaint about the Barnett Government's planned closure of remote West Australian communities. Mick Gooda says the treatment of Aboriginal people in the state could potentially be breaching human rights conventions.
The Indigenous Social Justice Commissioner says a national debate needs to be had over the West Australian Government's plans to stop providing essential services to many remote Aboriginal communities in the state. Mick Gooda says it can also be argued that the WA government is breaching international human rights agreements.
That's a human right. It's not an Indigenous right. It's a human right. So why aren't these people engaged in a conversation? Because I'm certain that these decisions will affect people, and we do have this human right.
The Prime Minister's given the issue international attention with his oversimplification of it, that now infamous lifestyle choice comment. The state government has a Royalty for Regions program which accumulated funds during the mining boom to be used in country Western Australia. However, that fund cannot be accessed by Aboriginal communities. Mick Gooda says Aboriginal people can make official complaints to the Human Rights Commission if they think that's racist or they're unhappy about community defunding.
Could be a group of people, it could be a town, it could be a single person who's affected by this policy. So I think I'd encourage people, if they think they are being treated in a racist manner, to ring the commission and we'll see about them lodging a complaint.
Another thing worrying the bush and many Aboriginal organisations is the Indigenous Advancement Strategy. First Nations groups are confused, angry and dejected, even some of those who successfully applied for more government funding. There are rumours that way less than half the newly funded organisations are actually Indigenous.
I'm going to be pretty disappointed if the numbers I've been hearing behind the scenes pan out the way they are at the moment, that a significant majority of organisations are non-Indigenous controlled.
Miles Morgan, NITV News.